on the last two things we have to discuss here. Nomenclature of spiro compounds. Write down nomenclature of spiro compounds. Spiro compounds are the compounds in which two rings are attached together with a quaternary carbon atom. Quaternary carbon, 4 degree. Carbon attached with 4 carbon. Quaternary carbon atom. For example, you see this. If you have a ring, this compound. Okay. It is a spiro compound because the two ring, which is the four member ring, this one cyclobutane and cyclopropane, attached with one common carbon atom. Why it is quaternary? Because this carbon attached with four carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3. We have this rule that will follow. Not that important, just we'll see some examples into this. Okay. So to write down the name of us.
So how can that carbon not be quaternary? Like any ring we have isn't it always quaternary?
No, if you have two cyclopropane attached together, it won't be.
Oh, it will be.
In this, it is possible. It is not quaternary. Okay. That compound is bicyclo compound. We'll discuss after this. Okay. Now to write down the name of this compound, we'll use prefix spiro. Okay? Spiro, and then we'll write down this bracket. And in the bracket, we'll write down the number of carbon atoms present in the two ring in ascending order, excluding the common carbon atom. So what we'll do here, this carbon atom, you let it be. We have to number the carbon atom in this ring. Okay? So this carbon, you let it be. We'll start the numbering from the lower ring, which is 1 and this is 2. Right? All these are rows. Numbering, we should start from the smaller ring. Right? 1, 2, then this carbon will be 3rd. And now we can write down this as 4th, this as 4th. These two positions are equivalent positions, so any one of these two carbon you can take as the fourth carbon. But if you have any substituents present here, then we have to bound to give this as fourth position. Got it? Okay. So this is 3, this one is 4, this one is 5, and this one is 6. Like this, we show that.
So what if two substituent groups, like one
will solve another? We'll take the example. Have some patience. Understood?
नहीं
दिल से नहीं करना है, रूल ठीक है. सो रूल इज व्हाट, व्हेन द टू रिंग्स आर अटैच्ड बाय वन कॉमन कार्बन एटम, इट इज अ स्पाइरो कंपाउंड. स्पाइरो कंपाउंड्स के लिए वी हैव रूल्स. ओके. So 1, 2, exclude this carbon atom. We have 2 carbon here and 3 carbon here. Right? How many total number of carbon atoms are what? Total number of carbon atoms are 6, right? So we'll write here this 2 carbon atom here and 3 carbon atom here. 2 dot 3, don't write comma here. Right? 2 dot 3. Total number of carbon atom is 6, so it is 6. This carbon you get into. How many carbon atoms in this ring? 1 and 2. 2 carbon atom here and 3 carbon atom here. So 2 dot 3. This number we always write in ascending order.
So, what if we have spiro 3.2 exit?
No, 3.2 we won't write.
No, sir, but is that not possible?
Compound is possible, but name is right, 3.2 is wrong.
No, sir, how will it look?
3.2 exit. 2.3 we can write. 3.2 we cannot say. 3.2, that's what I'm telling you. It must be descending order.
It must be ascending order.
2.2
we can. So, we have 3 of them.
It's like, yeah, one more thing.
Then that will become the substrate. We have to see that. Like this, if you have for an item. 5 12 ring in this, will have this, right? So this will take the thing and this becomes the subsequent on this.
So when that has double bond,
where?
So
then will also poison double bond.
Even then, that won't be the main.
No, if double bond is there, then this 2 and this will also subsequent. This 2 and this will also subsequent. But you won't get more than 2 ring in a compound. I haven't seen this bench. But if it is there, one becomes the subsequent, other 2 will take as the.
So the one with more number is mean.
If any functional group is not there. Understood this? Write down the name of this compound. This one.
And then one bottle attached. What the other?
The same?
Yeah.
No, attached to it.
No, attached to the pentyline.
So would that triangle be one side? Triangle is the smallest.
The longest is
the right long
one. I don't even know. What's the
smallest? So why do you start with the quadrilateral? Why do you start with the triangle?
No, I am trying to take the maximum number of carbon atoms.
So, but there we start from the
Where? We have only 2. We have to start from the smaller one. So, in this 2, this is the smaller one. In this 2, this is the smaller one.
So, but in those 2.
So, this won't give you the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are taking 2 at the time. 6 cyclopropyl.
3.5.
Spiro.
No, first line is spiro.
Yes, spiro.
3.5. 3.4. 3.4. 6 cyclopropyl octane.
So how do you know how to number it in this one? In
this one?
Yeah.
We always start for this year rule, we always start from the smaller ring. And this carbon we won't give this carbon as the first carbon, the common carbon. This is 1, this is 2, then it is 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, so it doesn't matter because here we are just going to
take the one.
So, so what did you say the name of?
It's spiral, 3, 5, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, sorry, 3.4, 6 cyclopropyl octane.
So is there a cycle between those squares?
No. Write down the name of this compound.
Septane.
Okay. This was happening only once.
He's a fake.
The last one right down. Bicyclo compound. Right on, when the two rings are joined together by two carbon atoms, then the compound is known as bicyclo compound. For example, you see, okay, this is a bicyclo compound. These two carbon atoms are
bridgehead.
Yes. This is, these two carbon are bridgehead carbon. Bridgehead carbon. This is two carbon bridge. This is also two carbon bridge, and this one is one carbon bridge. Now, is this what we have to do? Suppose we have to name this carbon and molecule. We'll start numbering from the bridgehead carbon. This carbon will start numbering. For example, you'll see, I'll write down this example now. We have this molecule, suppose. Okay, this molecule. So we'll start numbering from the bridgehead carbon, this carbon atom. How many carbon atom bridge we have? This side we have three carbon bridge. This side we have four carbon bridge. And here we have, there's no carbon present here. Right? So we'll start numbering from this carbon atom one. Right? And there we were going towards the smaller ring. Here we'll go towards the larger ring. Right? Just reverse of that. So we have to start from here. Larger ring is this ring. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay? We'll start from the bridgehead carbon and then towards the larger ring. Name of this compound is bicyclo. Okay? In this bracket, we'll write down the number of carbon atom in the bridge. Okay, and that will be in descending order. There we have in ascending order, here we have in descending order. So here we have 4 carbon atom, 3 carbon atom, and here we have 0. Right? So we'll write 4 dot, 3 dot, 0. Because this is 1. If this bond I'll write down this way, then 4 dot, dot, 8 dot, 3 dot, 1 here. But here we do not have any carbon atom. The bridgehead carbon are joined together directly like this. If the bridgehead carbon are joined together by any carbon atom, then that carbon atom will write down. Okay. Right. So 4 dot 3 dot 0.
The number of that carbon atom would be 7, right?
Where?
if it was bent, the number of the carbon atom at the bend of the bridge should be 7.
10th one. We'll do ring and last one we'll do. Like in this case, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay? So for this one, the name will be what? Bicyclo?
3 dot. No.
2 dot. 2 dot 1. Heptane.
So carbon 6 and 7 are not connected.
Yes, it's not connected. We'll number this carbon atom in the last.
The middle bridge is
called
carbon bridge.
Right?
Right.
Is that just
the exchange
of carbon bonds?
No, I have written this in this way. Actually, we have this to read.
What's
this ring, and we have one ring like this.
It's just 2 rings.
Junction.
Here also you see, one ring is this cyclic same, and one ring is this. These two carbon atoms, like this one. Here, these two carbon atoms.
So there's
joy. Here also you see, no? Here is this one. Cyclopentane, cyclohexane. These two carbon atoms are common.
So if we had the same bend in both of those,
so then both three carbon atoms are common. Both three carbon atoms.
No, no, we are separating this way. Right, to make you understand. But actually, you see, we have this ring, we are dealing with. See, we are taking this carbon atom, no, in the square bracket. This
so
one,
in this one, it will just be cyclohexane with the bond coming up, so we'll call it
that. No, you can take this way also, cyclohexane and the bond coming up, right? But when you define this as a bicyclohexane bond, then you must have to understand how the two rings are attached. And then when you try to separate this, you get this kind of structure. But since two carbon atoms are common here, right, so it is bicyclic. Here also you see, if you separate this, we get this two spring structure. Two carbon atoms.
So say if the 2, 5 and 9 and 7 had a bridge, how do we name it?
2, 5
and 9 and 7 had the same bridge.
Then you'll have 4 sides. You'll have 4 sides.
Wait, I'll draw another.
I didn't have 4 sides.
This is our two bridge carbon, one bridge carbon, four bridge carbon.
Someone else catches you.
So what if you go for like a 5 bridge?
Okay, this one, what is the name?
Is it
2.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0 Tell me the name of this one. This one bicyclo, okay, 2.2.2
Okay, so wait, wait, sir.
Yeah, it is bonded. Like it is the back side.
This is
Oh.
So how is that 7 and 8 not that?
Which one?
So like half
one,
six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So then an after 6?
Then 7 and 8.
So what about that?
So it shouldn't be that
this
way.
One. It is not the carbon atom. See, this is like this compound is like this. Okay? Two carbon atom. And here also we have 2 carbon atom.
It's a
3-dimensional structure.
So that's just a random.
Yes, it is going behind the planet.
It's not saying this 1, 4 bonded to this.
Take care? 2 carbon carbon bridge, two carbon bridge, two carbon bridge. Bicyclo.
How do you know that's a hydrogen?
Two dot, two dot, two. Octane. So finish this, we'll take a break. This one you copied on, this one you've written, no?
Yes. Okay.